Hey guys, welcome to this one. We're going to take a look at the next generation front end tooling for a development environment, and it is called Vite. So we're going to take a look at how to migrate a Mix project to a Vite project. Along the way, you'll get some valuable insight on how this is done, and we'll even provide some tips on how to make this process automated, and we'll take a look at how to get this server set up. Once again, guys, be sure to stick around for the entirety of the video as I give most of my insights towards the end of the lesson. All right, with that being said, let's jump in. Okay, guys, let's get this one sorted out. So this one is basically going to be about if you wanted to migrate from Laravel Mix to Vite. So let's just open up our browser here. And as you can see, I think it was as of version 19.19, somewhere there, Laravel changed the asset bundling to Vite. So it went from laravel.mix or Webpack to this front-end build tool. This may take a little getting used to if you're familiar with Webpack. These changes are actually kind of welcome. There's a lot of new things around that. And you don't have to use Vite if you don't need it. You can always bounce back to Mix or Webpack. So I'm just gonna show you guys how to take a basic generic Laravel package, something that's a little bit older. So I've installed a package here that is version 8.8324, and I'm using PHP 8.1, and we're gonna upgrade this project to Vite. So first things first, let's just make sure you have Node installed. So make sure you have a version of Node installed. So run node-v. Anything 16 or above is usually recommended. It works pretty well. Also, you might want to make sure you also have NPM running as well. So you will need these two for sure, Node and NPM. So we'll just clear that. So this is just a standard Laravel project. I just named it Mix. You notice that we have Webpack right here. So webpack.mix. I'm going to do a few things to kind of get Webpack up and running so that we can run Mix first to see how it works, and then after we do our changes, then run Vite and see how that has changed and what's new. So the files we're going to need are Webpack. We're going to need to take a look at the package.json file. We're going to take a look at the composer.json file. We'll actually need this one as well, git.ignore, and I believe we'll need our env, and in our resources directory up here we'll also need app.css and app.js and this one here, Bootstrap. Now, I could have just searched for them and brought them up, but I'm just going to lay them all out as these are the files that we'll be working with for this manual kind of update. Okay, so let's just make sure Webpack is running, and it actually shouldn't run right now. This is an alias that I'm using. So this is the same as npm run dev. I just have an alias here set up for npm run dev this way. Nothing's going on. So I'm going to install a few things just to kind of get us to compile some assets. I'm going to install Tailwind, Post CSS, and Auto Prefixer, and I'll even throw an Alpine there. And we're just going to install, this is the command, we're going to get the latest version of Tailwind, the latest version of Post CSS, and then the Auto Prefixer. And we're going to run this. So this is why you'll need NPM or Node. So next up, I'm going to install Alpine.js. I'm just going to install this. In our package.json file, we've added Tailwind with the latest version. We've added Post CSS, Auto Prefixer, and Alpine.js. So at this point right now, we need to just add, tell Mix what we need to compile as far as Tailwind, what we require. And this is all really, once again, totally isn't necessary, but I just want to make sure that this is compiled and we get some kind of generated output for using Webpack. So let's jump back over to our terminal. We'll run this. Okay, and something failed. What are we missing here? So we need to run one more command. I totally forgot this one. And we need to run npx tailwind css init-p, and this will generate our post-processing file. Here it is. And here we have the tailwind config file. And while we're here, we just need to import some framework boilerplate just so we can get this to work. Now we should be able to go back over here, run npm run dev, or that's my alias, but this is the same command. And we should be able to get Mix to compile. Okay, so that's good.
Hey guys, what's up? Kevin here. I just want to give a big shout out to my subscribers. If you haven't already subscribed, please do so. Be sure to give the videos a like, a thumbs up, and start a conversation. Much appreciated. Now let's get back to the video.
In this case, I just called the project mix.code. Okay, so here we are. This is our project running with Mix built out 8.33.24 and PHP 8.1. So now let's talk about Vite. So this is the next front end building tool that Laravel has moved on to. And there's a lot of documentation around this, and there's a few nuances that are not quite the same if you're familiar with Webpack, but I would give this a read. There is a couple of plugins that you will need for different APIs. There's a Laravel plugin, there's React, there's Vue. There's a bunch of things that actually make it worthwhile, and it is pretty fast, and depending on how your project is set up and what you're trying to accomplish. So let's just jump back over to the documentation, and we know we have our initial setup. We have node done. We can configure Vite. This is gonna be a step that we're gonna need, so we'll just keep this open. I'm gonna go back to our project, and I'm going to jump to the composer.json file over here. The first thing I'm going to work on is I'm going to upgrade the framework. We're sitting at 8.75 or higher, and that's why we're at this number here, 8.83.24. So we're just going to bump this up. I believe it was like 19.19, somewhere around there. Well, so anything greater than that, that should work out. And we're going to have to run a composer update for this to work as well. But for now, we're just going to try and chain some of these things manually. And once again, this is for educational purposes. If you wanted to automate this, there are tools out there that will do this for you fairly quickly, but this will give you a really wholesome understanding of what's really going on in the background. Let's move on to our package.json, just the file beside it. And we're gonna remove Mix here. We don't need this anymore, okay? We set it up and we had it working because we wanted to test what was going on with our initial build and having something, you know, being able to work for us in the beginning. So I'm just gonna clear this. I'm gonna uninstall Laravel Mix. So this should remove it from our package.json file. So if we come over here, this is now gone. Also, while I'm here, I'm gonna remove most of the scripts around Mix as well. We're gonna keep these two for now. We're gonna remove this. Okay, so this is gonna be dev. And instead of calling npm run development on Mix, we're going to call npm run development, and we're going to use Vite, okay? Because we're going to install that package in just a moment. And then instead of development here, we're just going to type in build. So this will be like when we publish to our production and we have all our assets versioned and, you know, sent to the public directory, ready for production. So we're going to say Vite, and we're going to say build. And I don't think I need this actually here. So this is pretty much done for now. And we're going to jump back out to our terminal, and we're gonna install Vite. So we're gonna say npm install, and we're gonna say Vite. We're gonna grab the latest version of that. So it might take a moment, depending on your computer. And the next thing we're gonna need is we're gonna install the Laravel Vite plugin. And we'll need this as well for our project to compile and use Vite. Notice that we're still at the same version of Laravel here, and we're at the same version of PHP. Nothing should have changed, but our dependencies have updated. We now have Laravel Vite plugin. We now have Laravel Vite, and these are the latest version as of this video. So we've configured Vite, we've updated our build scripts, we've added some dependencies, and we've bumped up the Laravel framework dependency. So next up is we're going to take a look at just removing this altogether. So we can just jump to the terminal if we wanted to here, and we're just going to remove webpack.mix.js. Okay, so if we go back over to our project, that file is no longer there. Let's go back to our browser and check our Vite documentation. So we'll go over here to guide, and we'll say getting started. So we're at the point here where we need to add our plugin, and in order to do so, we need to create this vite.config.js file. So this is where we're going to provide the plugin information that we need for our plugin. In our case, our plugin is going to be the laravel.vite plugin. Jumping back over to terminal, I'm just going to clear this for now, and I'm going to create this vite.config.js in the root directory of my project. And here's the config file. If we were to once again just go back to the browser and have a look at the Laravel documentation, I'm going to copy this and I'm going to place this inside of my config file. And the next thing that we're going to touch on is some of our ES modules. So let's go check around app.js. So previous to, you know, the Vite front end tool being applied, we had to require Bootstrap in this way. Now it's kind of doing the exact same thing, but we're using the import statement, and it'll be this bootstrap.js file minus the JS. Sorry about that, guys. And then we're just going to delete this as well. Okay. Just kind of clean this up. So we've removed the require and we just added the import. We'll have to do the same for the bootstrap.js ES module. So we're going to load the Axios library, and we're going to modify how we import Lodash. So we'll say import as well here. So now it's okay to actually remove this. We can delete this. We're going to need that window directive as well. So we're just going to actually bring this up here. Okay. And that should do it. And once again, instead of requiring Lodash like this, we're going to import this instead. So we're going to do it along the same lines. We're going to take Axios, and then just below it, we're going to use the window DOM again. So that should do it. This will leave the same. This header and the request width, we can leave the same. Nothing needs to change here. So I believe that we're done with the bootstrap. We're okay with the app.js. Nothing's really changing for our app.css at the moment. We're just using the Tailwind components, and we're building out Tailwind with the base utilities and components. We'll close that. Interestingly enough, we're gonna need to do something in our env file. So down here, we use this mix pusher app key and then mix pusher app cluster. The only difference here is we're gonna have to change this to Vite. Okay, so we're replacing the mix with Vite. Okay, so these environmental variables will have to change if you're using any of these things. When you try to build it out, it will give you a bug, it'll give you an error. Let's update this, because we called our project mix.code. I don't know, you don't really need to do this, but we'll just say mix. So we can close this one for now. So when we build out our project and you use the build method, it'll pop up inside of this public directory over here in a build folder, and this is where your production assets will be. So we need to add, just after hot, we could say /public, and we'll do build. And then we don't need anything else here, we can close this as well. So I think we've covered everything. I'll keep this one open. The config file is good, we need nothing here. Post CSS is good, so we're just importing Tailwind and the auto prefixer. So now we can actually give this a try. So let's just jump back out into our terminal. And then we'll run npm run dev. And based on all of our changes, we'll see that we get a local development server for Vite. And then over here, we have Laravel version 8.3.24. And this is our URL. I'm just going to open this link here. And this is our development server. And as you can see, this is our project right here. So if I was to just click on this link as well, it opens up another one. And believe it or not, this is being served. All the assets are being published using Vite, right? And the Vite server is running over here. So this is the development server that provides like hot module replacement and hot reload and stuff like that. So this is being run by Vite, not Webpack. I hope that makes sense. So one thing that's interesting is if we had our welcome.blade file, and right now we don't have any layouts or anything like that, but if you had any templates, you have to add the @vite_blade directive. So according to the Laravel documentation, when you want to process static assets, you're going to have to do something like vite@asset. You could do something along these lines if you were using like a layout or something like that. You just use the @directive, and this one is vite, and then you would point to where these files are. So in our case, I think it's, and the ladder for JavaScript would be roughly the same path, but it would be, you know, in the JS folder. So not to be confused. This is kind of along the lines of, you want something like this if you were like script, and let's say we're using mix, this would be mix, and in this case it'd be JS. That's what we're looking for, and it'd be app.js. So you're doing basically this here, and then you're doing the latter if you're doing, you know, CSS. Keep that in mind when you're working with Blade. The next thing would be you'd want to update your version of Laravel from 8 to 9. There is a guide, an upgrade guide that Laravel documentation provides, and it takes, it says like up to 30 minutes, and there's a lot of things that are required. So depending on your project and what your requirements are, this could, you know, take some time, and because you're doing it manually, you could be prone to a lot of errors and a lot of mistakes, and you may miss some things that you wouldn't normally catch. Now I'd recommend, if your project is fairly big, or, you know, you wanted some automated way to do that, I recommend checking out Laravel Shift. It's a great tool. It's really wild how it can help you upgrade your project and find some things that you could be missing, or things that you need that you wouldn't have already thought of, or, you know, done so by doing a manual upgrade. Now for this video, we did do Vite, and we added this manually, and we were able to check this out and see how the development server works. I just wanted to give you, like, guys, are kind of a grasp of how it's done behind the scenes as far as an educational thing. You know, the process that I used here could be done, and you could get away with some things on a fresh project that you just installed, where there's nothing really too complicated or anything that can get mismanaged. But, you know, if you had a whole bunch of other things going on in here, like some of the template work with Livewire, perhaps like live reloading with Blade, you know, even sail or something, or telescope, or you had tests that you're running or something like along those lines, this process would be a little bit more of a steep incline as far as the learning curve. Okay, so I think that's it. Hope you learned a lot with that one. I can close all this stuff, but I mean, it's really not bad how they made it kind of backwards compatible. Like you could jump between, you know, Vite and then jump back to Mix and still have your assets compiled. There are some caveats, some things that like I miss, like that were from Webpack that were kind of convenient, and that can be done in, you know, in Vite. It's just the learning curve is a little bit different. So certain things like when you're importing your directories or whatever, you'd have to check out the documentation. And I believe it's something along the lines of going to your app.js file and as simple as adding this at import global meta just to grab your things that you want. So when it compiles, it ends up in your public directory or your production. Okay, take care, guys. I'll see you in the next one. I hope this was good and you found some information and you found this useful. And I'll see you next time.